Looking for the cheapest coins on the internet right now? Look no further than my sponsor, Muck Coin Bank, guys. You seriously cannot beat that value. I promise. Use code Poodle for 5% off your order.
What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today, we have quite a few things. First, we have the final Wildcard Wednesday of the Madden 21 season, guys. We have some golden ticket reveal slash news to go over. And we have Mutt Rewards All-Pro tier that I did see in my unopened packs here. So I'm going to get started with that, guys, in just a second. But before we get into today's video, make sure you're down below, hit that subscribe button, turn on that noti bell, give this video a big thumbs up as always, guys. If you need coins for any of the new veterans for whatever reason, make sure to head on down below and use code Poodle at checkout for 5% off. Guys, anyways, if you guys are excited for the last Wildcard Wednesday, give this video a big thumbs up, guys. Again, it's veterans. We know the deal. But it's still the final Wildcard Wednesday, so get excited, I guess. And of course, guys, we have some golden ticket news and the All-Pro tier packs. So let's start with the All-Pro tier packs here real quick. Let's get into this and see what we got. So NFL Draft Pass pack, so that's pretty cool. A pack that I otherwise wouldn't have spent coins on, so it gives me a chance to try to pull some. We get a draft reveal right there. 93 Bradley Bozeman, or Bozeman. That's actually not bad right there. We do get a goal. Oh, what is this? Carl Banks, 92 overall. Okay, I wasn't sure if that was the high one. We get a Mud Heroes card, 89 Sean Lee, and we get an Elite. Okay, I'll take that. Actually wasn't that bad of a pack. I got a lot there. I'm not sure if that's a typical pull rate of those packs, but that pack wasn't actually that horrible. How much is a typical draft pack? Ooh, no, I don't want to do that. How much is the typical draft pack? I like to always see when I get some value there. Draft pass pack. Is it still on the block? Draft blast pack. That's a little different there. Draft pass. Okay, I don't even know if they sell the draft pass packs any. Oh yeah, they do. Okay, so it's a $100,000 pack. Sorry, 100,000 coin pack, or a $15 pack, or 13 give or take with the axe. That's not horrible, actually. Okay, I'll take that for free. That's not bad, just for being a part of the Mutt Rewards program. But guys, heading over to the veterans, and then go over some of the golden ticket stuff. So let's head over to veterans. I'll go over the golden ticket stuff as we get there. Now for the final veterans, there's gonna be 5 as per usual. It's the weekly stuff, guys. This is the last weekly content. Like, this is the last week of weekly content for the most part. So that's it. That's it for just about the entire year. So let's start here. We got Bradley McDougal, who actually had a pretty good card early in the year, if I'm not mistaken. 95 speed, 95 excel, 91 tackle, 96 play rec, 89 pursuit, 88 man, 92 zone, 84 hit power. So guys, the hit power is actually decent. I guess for a strong safety, guys, isn't horrible. He's going to have decent enough speed to get to 97 speed, 95 excel. He will have above 90 man. He'll have close to like 97 zone. And he has 84 man. He's a well-rounded safety. I guess good on a Jets team. But again, you could just put, you have Jamal Adams and I think Marcus May. So Bradley McDougal probably is going to be useless because, again, you have Marcus May and you have Jamal Adams. He's not good on a Jets team. Maybe you can put him at linebacker or something, right? I mean, maybe. 85 catching is not bad. 8 change of direction is a little bit low. Block shed is going to be a low 62. Yeah, this card really isn't that usable at all. Not a great card. I do see Shady McCoy, though, so let's get to him. Shady McCoy, halfback for the Buccaneers. 95 speed again. I need to cut the crap with this 95 speed. I'm tired of seeing it. 96 agility. I'm sorry, 97 agility, 96 excel, 90 carrying, 79 catching is decent, 97 change of direction, 63 trucking, 90 break tackle. Let's see what we got here. So this card can't be powered up, of course, but he will get 97 speed. He can get up to possibly above 80 catching if you use the right chems on him. His change of direction is really high. Will be a good, probably a good theme back, possibly in the Buccaneers. Although there's probably gonna be some other options. I mean, the Buccaneers doesn't have like a wide variety of options, so it's possibly usable. Behind the card, he has 96 juking, which is good. He has 81 step farm, which is decent. 83 catching traffic is not bad. If you do put catching stuff on him, like play fake and stuff, his medium route running, catching, and everything will go up, which actually make him pretty good. Short running is good as well. Really good route running back, to be completely honest. Then we got John Bostic, middle linebacker for the Washington football team. 92 speed, 96 excel, makes him a very slow linebacker at a position that people don't like. So off the rip, he's probably dead. 80 strength, decent. 96 tackle is good. 95 play rec is good. 94 block shed is good. 95 hit power is good. And 68 zone, again, unusable. If you're going to have a linebacker out there, he's got to be really good at zone, right? So not the greatest. Again, these cards are usable maybe if you know, like, if you're going against a guy who runs like 95% of the time, you could start coming out in bear formations where you just have a bunch of linebackers out there to stop the run. That's usable, but again, sometimes safety still do the job better. But guys, while we wait for these next two to go up, let's go. Oh, we have Amendola up, but let's go over some of the golden ticket news here, guys. So tonight at 7:30, during the Madden Bowl, day 4 of the Madden Bowl, I believe, guys, they will be revealing the entire list of all the golden tickets. These aren't confirmed golden tickets, right? Like how we had confirmed golden tickets. Like, this is the official list. Like, EA already talked to everyone. They finalized them. And remember, we probably only know about 6 to 8 to maybe 10 of the tickets through YouTubers who corroborated on them through people who have confirmed them on Twitter. But we do not know all the people who don't watch YouTube or who aren't on Twitter, who don't communicate like that, and they just made their own, right? So tonight we will have the official list of the entire release of golden tickets. Now, will there be a schedule to it yet? Probably not, or they may have them, but they're not going to tell us. Typically, it's kind of like a surprise format. Like every week, we just wait for the drop and we get like a pre-reveal. But that will be tonight at 7:30 p.m. Eastern time during the Madden Bowl. They're going to give the entire list of golden tickets. Again, you don't have to come out to it. You can just wait for someone who, you know, a YouTuber to tweet it out. You can just wait for it to be on Twitter, for people to talk about it, or for a YouTube video to be made on it. But it's going to be exciting, guys. You're going to see everyone. So we know a few. We know the Tebows, the Dell Pitts, the Derek Robertsons. We know the Brandon Ayuk potentially. I hope the Ayuk, someone changed that because of this 99 Ayuk, or that it was denied for that reason. But nonetheless, the thing is here, it's going to be exciting. Hopefully, I'm hoping to see a Saquon in there. A Saquon, maybe an Aaron Rodgers. There's a few exciting guys. Metcalf wide receiver. There's a few guys I really want to see in this drop, so it's exciting to see who are going to be surprise ones. We have more surprise ones this year than at least we thought we did last year. This year, I feel like we have more. Could be wrong. But let's get into these final veterans, guys, before we close out this video. We got Danny Amendola for the Lions. 94 speed. That's kind of low. That's really low. 87 jumping, kind of low as well when you're 5'11". 96 catching, 94 catching traffic, 92 spec, 95 short route running, 92 medium, and 86 deep route running. He can get all 90 route running at least, which is good. He'll be a decent route runner on maybe a Lions theme team. Or if he could have gotten it, Patriots, but I don't think he can because no power up. I don't remember if veterans can automatically get all team chems because they're veterans. I think they might be able to. I could be wrong. I forget what that... But this car is not horrible. I mean, it's decent. Okay, I'm sorry. On a theme team, it's not horrible. In general, the card's horrible. That's how I should say that. He does have good agility, 95 agility, 97 excel, 92 change of direction, 93 juke. With the ball in his hand, he's actually really, really good. He's a decent card in that aspect. And then we have Nick Foles, 96 overall Nick Foles. Guys, this is the banger, right? This is the end of the year wildcard ones that we got. Kind of upsetting, but you know, it's still content. 77 speed, decent for a Nick Foles card. 95 throw power is good, 95 short's good, 93 medium, 92 deep. 94 throw under pressure, 90 throw in the run, and 94 play action. So, chemmed up and everything, he will have 99 throw power, 99 throw short, and 98 throw medium. Left him at a 92 throw deep. The card overall can't be powered up, so it's going to hurt him. 6'6 is a good height. 80 excel is not horrible. Let's see behind the card. Can he get anything good? Break sacks only an 80, which I guess for Nick Foles, again, not horrible. Throw under pressure, 94. The card's not good, right? It's not a good card. Honestly, out of all these cards, if I had to rank them, worst one here is going to probably be Danny Amendola. Second worst, probably John Bostic. Third worst, Nick Foles. I guess I'd give Shady McCoy as second worst. And Bradley McDougal is probably the best. Because, again, he still has a decent speed. Still has a strong safety. Still can be used in a lot of more ways than LeSean McCoy could probably be used. I mean, and it's funny because I said McDougal was almost useless. But in comparison to the other guys, he's less useless, right? But that's about it for the video. Hopefully, you guys did enjoy. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Turn that notification bell. Give this video a big thumbs up. If you guys need coins, head on down below. Use the link in the description. Use code Poodle at checkout 5% off. Thanks for watching. I'm out. Peace.